Hello students, this is the 11th video of sexual reproduction in flowering plants and topic covered in this video is development of monocot embryo or development of embryo in monocotyledons. So let's start. Development of monocot embryo starts from the zygote stage. This zygote is formed by the fusion of male gamete with the egg, and the process is called syngamy. So, in the first stage or the zygote stage, zygote is formed. After the zygote is formed, it divides into three cells: the terminal cell, the basal cell and the middle cell. This is called three-celled stage, as zygote has divided into three cells. The basal cell does not divide further, and middle cell gives rise to most of the embryo. The parts of the embryo that are formed from the middle cell are epicotyle, hypocotyle, suspensor, plumule and the radical. And the terminal cell forms the cotyledon. In monocot, there is only one cotyledon. After the three-celled stage comes the stage of elongation. In this stage, the terminal cell and the middle cell start their division. As you can see in the diagram, the middle cell shown in pink color has started its division. And terminal cell, which is shown in brown color, has also started its division. The basal cell shown in red color remains as it is. It does not divide. After the stage of elongation comes the stage of mature embryo. Now terminal cell will give rise to cotyledon, as we have seen earlier. Terminal cell has given rise to the cotyledon. Terminal cell is also shown in brown color and cotyledons are also shown in brown color. Middle cell will form most of the embryo. As you can see, most of the embryo is shown by pink color, which is formed by the middle cell. For example, epicotyle, hypocotyle, plumule, radical and the suspensor. And the basal cell, which is shown in red color, will remain as it is. Hence, a mature embryo will be formed. The epicotyle, which will end in plumule, has a covering called coleoptile, and the hypocotyle, which ends in radical, has a covering called as coleorhiza. Now let us look at structure of monocot embryo. Monocot embryo has only one cotyledon, and that cotyledon in grass family is called scutellum. Scutellum or the cotyledon is situated towards lateral side of embryo. As you can see, cotyledon is situated towards the lateral side of the embryo. Part of embryo above the level of scutellum is epicotyle, which ends in shoot apex. And part of embryo below the level of cotyledon is hypocotyle, which ends in radical. The shoot apex is covered by a sheath of cell called coleoptile, and the radical is covered by a sheath of cell called coleorhiza. So covering of radical is coleorhiza and covering of shoot apex is coleoptile. Now let us look at structure of maize grain. The outer layer surrounding the whole grain is called pericarp. As you can see, the outer layer surrounding the whole grain is called pericarp. Now, the bigger portion is the endosperm. This portion is the endosperm and this is rich in starch. And the endosperm has an outer layer, as you can see, which is marked in yellow. The endosperm has outer layer, which is called aleuron layer. This aleuron layer is rich in proteins. On one side of endosperm lies the scutellum or the cotyledon. Now, the plumule is covered by a shell of cell called coleoptile, and the radicle is covered by a shell of cell which is called coleorhiza. So, if you have gained something from this video, please subscribe now to my channel Ramji Chopra, comment, like, and share.